Special care units, dementia care units.
In early 2010, the VA Innovation Initiative, known as VAI2, was launched to bring fresh thinking to solve departmental challenges, gathering ideas from VA employees, entrepreneurs, and industry. VA has created a mechanism that brings private sector style competition and agility to public service. The result is a portfolio of more than 120 funded innovations. One of those is an idea presented by the Specialty Care Clinic at the VA Hospital in Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania. As we will see, they created a whole new environment to help their very special patients.
You've done this before, right, Herbie?
Well, this is our multisensory environment, and the multisensory environment is made to target the different senses of people who have dementia or Alzheimer's disease. What we do is we try to get them to come into our environment here, and it's a structured area. We can provide comfort and safety, and we're trying to engage them back into reality.
And those caissons go rolling along.
In 2011, there was an email sent out asking for different ideas how to better the VA and how we can help our veterans. So I wrote a small little blurb about how special care units need to have some more training, and we need to have multisensory environments so we could be helping our veterans achieve the maximum potential while they're living with us. Fortunately, my idea was chosen to continue, and it received funding. So today we're going to do an activity, and from this funding we were able to have different training opportunities, to have different sensitivity training, and to purchase the equipment for a multisensory environment. Well, when people are diagnosed with Alzheimer or related dementia, a lot of the physiological problems come along with that. They start to lose their different levels of functioning with their speech, maybe, or their ability to walk or feed themselves. Depending on what their function ability is and what they like to do, we are able to coordinate a program with that veteran that's specifically geared towards them.
I'm an occupational therapist. I've worked at the VA for approximately 6 years now. I came prior to that from pediatrics, and I'm only stating that because my specialization before was autism. And autism has lent its way well to transition to dementia, because a lot of the strategies, such as this multisensory room, are used with both populations.
When we won the innovation grant, we were able to contract with a company called Dementia Care Specialists. Dementia Care Specialists came to our facility, and they completed a train-the-trainer program.
How would you define function?
There are seven of us who are trained to provide education for the rest of the staff in the community living center, as well as the hospitals and our community outreach programs.
I am repairing the fence with a hammer and nails.
We go through all of behaviors that you might see with someone who has dementia or Alzheimer's disease. The focus of our training is not what people are losing, is that what abilities still remain. So we want to always focus on the positive, what's still remaining abilities for the veterans that we are serving. Your job is to get her to stand up, but you have to do what's on that card before she can do that.
So yeah, I was hoping we'd go to the store together and do a little shopping. You know, we could buy you a new outfit or something, maybe catch the bus or a taxi, or we go for a bike ride. You wanna go outside for a little bit, get some fresh air?
Yes.
All right,
we're going to do now is a virtual dementia tour. We're going to simulate what some of the physical disabilities feel like that our veterans have every day.
Put the goggles on to simulate macular degeneration. So the email goes out, and anyone who is interested in this can join and ask to be part of the training.
I can't hear anything you're saying.
What you're going to do today is set the table and match the colored socks. As they go through the continuum with dementia, their visual field will narrow. It tends to end up being about a 12 to 18 inch box, which is sort of in front of their eyes. They have a tendency to not look up and seldom look down. Not looking down becomes a hazard when they're walking with a walker. You want to maintain the upward gaze as long as you can, so you're going to try to use stimulating things like the bubble tube. So that's what the goal of all of this is to really get you know, give them quality of life as we help them share the end of their journey and have this sensory impact so that they can, you know, have an enjoyable, meaningful final days, you know, that it's not with chemicals and drugs and medications.
When they have problems with their vision, macular degeneration, glaucoma, some cataracts, they have a harder time being able to see. We all know that when we were kids, we enjoyed looking through kaleidoscopes and seeing the different colors. Well, now we're able to do that with them again. Just by touching the screen and moving your finger along the screen, it has a kaleidoscope effect.
From the sensory perspective, what a weighted blanket does is it triggers the proprioceptive system, and what that is just deep pressure, but it's very calming and it's also organizing. So if somebody's very, like, feels out of control, this has an organizing effect that's gonna let them help calm down a little bit.
This is a lighted system where we can put different colors onto the wall. So if someone's favorite color is red, blue, green, or yellow, that can be there and it can help soothe them. It can also change different colors as well.
That's the way. One more push.
Perfect.
Good. It's really neat to see the people come in and see their life change when they have meaning and they're focused and you're accommodating them and not doing for. You know, because it's so easy to put someone's shirt on. It's so much harder to stand back and watch them struggle through it, but that's the goal.
I was in World War II.
I know.
That was quite something I never forget.
That's the hard part, is just watching them, not necessarily struggle through it, but be able to do it and realize a sense of accomplishment, because nobody wants to be totally dependent.
Mm-hmm. Going through things with the big red one, that's something. When we actually fought in Europe and fought the Germans, and I was part of that, so.
We love you, Daniel.
Thanks.
To learn more, or submit your own innovative idea to VAI2, please visit the website on your screen.